it's on some fully lit psycho. A 10 side beats to a 9 beats, but hey, she outlined it. Shouldn't even matter.
Yo, Jenny Gang, what it do? Yes, we are back. It's another Jenny Gang production. Before I even start the video, please hit the like button. Thank you to everybody who already does. Thank you to my current subscribers. If you haven't hit the like button, just tap it. It's not gonna cost you anything. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, you're obviously late, so go ahead and sub up. Anyways, today I want to talk about the disagreement or argument or whatever y'all want to call it between Mr. Wack 100 and, let's make sure we get this guy's name, Rocky Rock from Sleepless LA, whatever that means. I'm pretty sure it's some type of gang title, what have you, but yeah, Mr. Rocky Rock, whatever your professional name is, shout out to you. So we live in a time where people do anything for clout, right? So whether you are a public figure or you just a regular 9-to-5 person, you're Warren Buffett, which means you get money, you're a public figure, but you're not an entertainer. One thing that you probably would not imagine that would happen to you after your death is if your death were caught on camera, you probably wouldn't expect someone that calls themselves your man or your homeboy or your homegirl to be one of the first people posting your homicide online, especially when they are a public figure, especially when they done it all for clout. They've already, you know, met success. They manage major artists like Blueface and a few other people, and they so-called made it out of the hood and ain't gotta do hood ninja-ish, right? But no, like I said, this is the do anything for clout era. So let's define the term do anything for clout for all of the people here who don't understand what that means. All right, do anything for clout means the ability to influence and to do things that others can't do because of your reputation, money, or power. Clout is the ability to get your message across and have it resonate, and it can be measured in dollars. I don't really think I like that meaning. Okay, I don't like that meaning. Basically, clout to me, in layman's terms, it's attention, you know what I'm saying? But it could be good attention, bad attention, but whatever you're doing, you're trying to get people's attention, whether it's in a positive, negative light, you know what I'm saying? You could be praying, you could be jumping off a 9-story building. You're hoping to capture a lot of people's attention and have the shine on you. Now, is doing certain things for clout necessarily bad? No. I do things for clout, but I try to turn it into money. I would never want clout just to have clout, right? So this brings me to my irritation with Wack 100. The name is very befitting of him. Not a big fan of this guy in the first place. LA people, I allow objective opinions on my page. I don't allow anything else. So that means we can disagree, but we're not going to go back and forth. But I'm not a fan of Wack 100, point blank, period. I think his attitude has been nasty prior to him developing a reputation on Clubhouse. So, since he is already rich, already famous, already has done it for clout and made it, I would say there is absolutely no reason why he should have posted his homeboy's murder in his Clubhouse or wherever he posted it. So, basically, the Rocky Rock guy was checking him because, you know what I'm saying, he was cool with Slim 100 as well, or excuse me, 400 as well, and he was telling him basically that that was wrong for him to post that, like, you know what I'm saying? And before Rocky started checking Wack 100, it's funny because he was trying to say all these things to let people know that he was cool with old boy before they passed away. Oh, I told him he needed to stop doing this, and I told him he needed to stop doing that. And then, you know, you proceed to, prior to this conversation, you ain't mentioned that you done posted him taking his last breaths and fighting for his life. Like, never like to put myself in any of these situations, but I would say, I would expect my friends to be going on every site they see, trying to get it taken out. You know what I'm saying? It's very degrading. It's very, you know what I'm saying? I don't know. What kind of homeboy is he? Because I don't need no homeboys and homegirls like that. I'm gonna just tell y'all right now. Rocky, you are the man. I hope you gain a platform. You may already have one. If you do, I have been looking for it, but I haven't been able to find just you. All of these clips that I find are like mainly him and Wack going back and forth. Him basically checking Wack like a man. He wasn't saying anything like out of the way, and he was just basically, everything Wack was trying to say to make it seem like it was justified for him to post that clip, he was debunking it. So let's look at it from an adverse side. Let's play devil's advocate. Wack might have felt like, okay, I can post his video. It's gonna get posted anyway because it's, you know, on film. Somebody gonna make money off of it. It might as well be me because I'm in possession of the video and it's my homeboy. Okay, that's where you come to the point of dignity. Okay, yeah, they gonna post it, but like I said, if you are any type of friend, or you talking about you was giving him so much guidance before he passed away, somebody should have guided you and told you don't put that up, and that's not cool. You should have been one of the people fighting to take the video down. So that is looking at it from devil's advocate side. Somebody's gonna post it, so I might as well too. Okay, they might not be his friends. They might just be ordinary clout chasers. They may be enemies. They may be the people that done it, because we don't know who done it or whatever. If y'all seen the video, he did try to jump and fight the person. I had to watch it a few times to actually see that was him outside the car trying to combat the gunfire, it looked like, almost. But let's listen to a little bit of this conversation between Wack and Mr. Rocky.
Homie posted a video of me, niggas.
Hey, man, the video everywhere, my nigga.
If a nigga posted a video,
the video everywhere, though, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? I bet it would have been a Crip, nigga. You wouldn't have boomed it.
Oh, shit, you sound like a Crip then.
No, I'm just saying, nigga, don't matter to me.
What the fuck Crip got to do with me, nigga?
Because, nigga.
A Crip ain't got nothing to do with me, nigga.
Man, no, nigga, we ain't gang banging in the room,
nigga. A Crip ain't got nothing to do with me.
We ain't gang banging in the room, bro.
A Crip ain't got nothing to do with me.
This ain't a blood room, my nigga.
A Crip ain't got nothing to do with me.
This ain't no blood room, nigga.
This ain't no blood room. This my room.
It ain't no blood room, Crip room, none of that. It's a fucking information. It's an information room, my nigga.
I don't give a fuck about none of that. If it was a Crip or none of that, my nigga.
Hey, my nigga, check this out, bro. You overstepping your boundaries, bro.
I'm not overstepping shit.
Hold on. I guess I'm reacting to it, y'all. I apologize. How was a dude overstepping his boundaries? You know why? Because he's not deriding Wack 100 like all the rest of these dudes that be in the room. He's telling him that he's wrong about what he's doing. So now you're overstepping his boundaries. Wack, if you had any sense, you would want this dude to stand beside you strong and tall, because he's not a yes man. All right, sorry, y'all.
It was father's decision, Rocky. Hey, Rocky. You, bro, let's stop acting like, bro. Hey, bro, you only got this fucking room because I pressed the bitch. If there's five of us, nigga,
man, you got no problem, nigga. This is my room. I don't give a fuck about that room, nigga. What you
are
saying?
Are you for real,
nigga?
My nigga?
Fuck
are
that room, nigga.
Right now? Are you for real?
The fuck, yeah.
It
nigga
was your room when the bitch took it.
So
on
what?
My room.
So what?
So, nigga, who is you to come in?
Nigga, me. Nigga, me. Nigga, the nigga who ended it. Nigga, the nigga who ended it. The nigga who ended it.
What?
The nigga who ended it, nigga.
Hey, look, all right, bro. Fuck this room. I send the shit everywhere else. You want some other shit, nigga? You want some other shit,
my nigga? Anyway?
Crenshaw, where Crenshaw come from? I ain't never in that room, nigga. Weird, that's weird, nigga.
Yeah, okay. Let's
nigga, you won't never see me and Crenshaw, nigga. That's weird. Yeah, I don't see Crenshaw nothing. I don't see Crenshaw nothing, nigga.
I'll send it to somebody else. Nigga, I don't care about that.
Man, end of the day, this ain't no cripple blood. blood room, nigga.
I didn't
it's
say
clubhouse.
It was a blood thing, nigga. I never said it was a Crip or blood thing.
Nigga, that's not how you playing it.
No, it's not, nigga.
That's how you playing it.
Don't post no video. Nigga, I said if a nigga post a video of me getting killed, nigga, and
it's gonna go up anyway.
Yo, hey,
Rock, you know some real shit? It probably would never be a video of you up because you're not a public figure like that. That's why it was up.
Good.
Let's just be real.
Good.
Like everybody got
posted. And you would probably post it, my nigga, if it was out.
Hey, public figure shit.
You would probably post it if it was out.
You're not a public figure like that, bro.
You would probably post it if it was out.
We're talking about public figure conversation.
You would probably post it if it was out.
And just to get credit, y'all, I did choose this video from Internet Chop's page. I don't know, just because it was one of the first few that came up to me that had the parts that I wanted to include in the video. So let's talk about their last little piece for a second. You basically try to take a shot at him and say, oh, even if you did get, you know what I'm saying, sent to the afterlife on camera, it wouldn't be viral because you're not a public figure. Okay, that is exactly the point I'm making. You are a public figure, a so-called self-made, all this, made it out the mud, all this. So why do you still feel the need to do things for clout? Why? You just proved his point. You a public figure and you supposed to be the dude, homeboy. If that dude came back to life today, what would your justification be for doing that? There would be none other than I was chasing clout and I supposedly don't have to. Now, if you ain't got it all the way together the way you pretending to with us, let us know something so we can say, well, I need these views. You need to, you know what I'm saying? But for as far as I know, you're made. You know what I'm saying? I never was crazy about your personality. And the reason why I'm saying it like I'm talking to him, because it seems like these little clubhouse things is getting around very quickly, but it's no disrespect, you know? Everybody's entitled to their opinion, but I ain't never liked Wack's opinion. And now that he's got a clubhouse, I just see even further, like my spirit, some people's spirits just don't vibe with other people's spirits and intentions. My spirit never vibe with his. And everybody that's like chasing after him, man, what y'all should have been doing is what Rocky did, standing up to him. Now he can get his own platform. He can be his own leader. Not to say that he wasn't already, but everybody gonna respect this man more for checking somebody who so-called got money and out the hood and all that. So I'm gonna link probably the sound maybe in a different video, so the video won't be so long, but let me know what you think in the comments. Again, you can disagree with me, but you do it respectfully. You know what I'm saying? R.I.P. Slim 400. Never heard one song. And if I did, I don't even know what it is. But there's a certain way to me that you handle death. You know what I'm saying? I won't get into things, you know. But when you pass away, you literally can't do anything else in human form. Why do you have to be further degraded? We know social media is going to degrade you. But your own homeboy? Just like Hassan Campbell jumping on the internet the other day to blast his homeboy Five God for, you know, getting, you know, whatever happened to him, and then basically making it seem like the same thing. Oh, I told him to not to, bro, you did that for clout. You wasn't doing that for support. We see straight through you, and hopefully Five God does too. I think he does, though. I think he really don't rock with you like that. Hurry up and get him a record deal so he can cut you off the way he needs to, because he ain't paying attention to his circle before it hurts him. Anyway, that's a whole nother video. Like, share, subscribe. This outfit that I have on is a one piece from my new business, Plush Posh Official. The official launch date will be January the 7th, 2022. I'm excited, and I want you guys to be excited too. Follow the link that I post in the videos. We will be going live on this page sometime soon. Super nervous, but we got to go ahead and break that ice so we can get bonded. See y'all on the next one.